been working in infectious diseases and HIV for over 20 years. And in my career, we've seen this disease evolve from a death sentence to a chronic treatable disease.
I think it's important to test for HIV, especially us as primary care physicians, because as you know, HIV has been on the rise in our communities. And that's why just about 99.9% of my patients are tested for HIV.
What I find often is that a lot of primary care providers will not test because they don't know what to do when they find a positive. From two areas, one, what do I tell a patient? And then two, what do I do with them? It's something that's called the five P's, where you ask patients about their partners, their practices, protection, pregnancy, and prevention. Keep in mind that sexual health is part and parcel of the review of systems. You can ask about hypertension, diabetes, bowel habits, without talking about sexual health. It's part and parcel of what a patient is about and who they are, and what your responsibility is as a primary care physician.
I think more primary care providers don't test for HIV for two reasons. The first reason is we really stopped talking about HIV 2 decades ago, at a time when we didn't have good treatments and this was seen as a specialist disease. The second reason is that we have biases about who has HIV and who should be tested for HIV.
I can tell you about a patient of mine who was diagnosed with HIV not by her primary care physician, despite the fact that she'd seen her provider over a number of years. But we came across her, an inpatient, where she was diagnosed with an AIDS-defining condition. She'd been married to her husband for about 25 years, but he passed away from unknown causes. And then we were called to the floor because the providers on the floor figured that this might be a patient who had something else going on. And so we recommended an HIV test, and we found that she was HIV positive with AIDS with a CD4 count of 4, and she had PCP pneumonia. When she found out, she was crying. She could not understand. She says that she had high blood pressure, so she goes to her primary care physician twice a year. And she couldn't understand why no one ever tested her all these years.
My advice to physicians who think that they should not test for HIV. First line, we should put ourselves in the background and the patient up front. Especially nowadays, because the therapy for HIV is so advanced compared to when I was in medical school at Howard, that we can actually take one pill. So compliance is way up because of the fact that the therapy is so much advanced. And we do know that the patients can live an active life and actually die from other causes and not necessarily HIV.